And cut.
What's up, Bulldogs?
Welcome back to another episode of PNN.
In today's episode, we'll start by hearing about the personal experiences of those moved by a local organization aimed at ending homelessness, watch two friends swap sports in an exciting new segment, hear an important reminder about combating school burnout as AP exams approach, and finish off with a recap of prom in this week's episode of Life.
But before we get started, let's get into some announcements.
Jonathan, I know we say this almost every time, but it's actually insane how fast we're approaching the end of the school year.
I know. AP tests are starting next week, so make sure to check the College Board website or the Portola calendar to check when and where your exams will be. All right, that's it for announcements.
If there's one organization to remind us of how blessed we are, it's certainly this next piece. We had the privilege of hearing about the moving work of OC Rescue Mission.
Just like how high school can be challenging, everyone needs a helping hand. In the midst of hopelessness, one organization shines bright.
My name is Jamie. I work at the Orange County Rescue Mission. I've been here for 3.5 years now, and I work in our donor relations department.
But OC Rescue Mission is so much more than the average homeless shelter. For one,
we call our resident students here, no matter their age, because we just want to cultivate this as an environment of learning. I love mainly the interactions I get to have with the families and individuals that are in our program. It's just the highlight of my day to be able to talk about God too, because this being one of the few faith-based programs in Orange County, it does set us apart. We do let people know up front we are a faith-based program. It is incorporated into parts of our curriculum and everything, but you don't have to be. It's never forced. We have people from all different kinds of religions and backgrounds and a very diverse group of people that come here.
And like Jamie said, everyone has a unique story, but the best ones inspire a change in others.
My name is Gina, and I'm a donor relations manager here at the Orange County Rescue Mission.
Just like so many others here at OC Rescue Mission, Gina is working here full time. But in order for her to reach her current position, it took courage, perseverance, and most importantly, hope.
So I actually am a graduate of this program. I graduated in 2021. Prior to coming to the Orange County Rescue Mission, I grew up in a family of alcoholism and addiction. And that put me on a path that was pretty destructive, making poor choices, not having really anybody.
Thankfully, Gina spoke up.
He was verbally abusive, and because he wasn't hitting us, I didn't think it was considered abuse, but ultimately finding out that it was abusive. After his fit of rages, he would buy us extravagant gifts to say he was sorry. And one of the gifts that he bought my daughter when she was 8 years old was a puppy. And I can remember clear as day, we got into a really huge argument, and she had her puppy in her arm, and she could hear her dad and I arguing, and she came walking down the stairs, and she said to me, "Mommy, I'll leave my puppy here if we never have to come back." So I realized at that moment that I needed to get out of that environment, and I needed to change her future. And so someone told me about the Orange County Rescue Mission, and that's how I got, decided to join the program.
And although it can be anything but easy to ask for help, it is important to reach out to the resources around you.
I think I just really believe in this program, and I've worked in other programs before. I've worked with foster youth before this, and I've really seen just how difficult life circumstances can lead to such brokenness and how hard it is to really get out of those situations. And in this program, it's very rare to have a program where every single service that a person needs is in one place.
That is exactly what OC Rescue Mission is. From clean bedrooms to computer labs and home-cooked food, it truly is a home away from home.
You get to get a second chance. You get to put your life on hold and work on the things that caused you to be homeless.
I truly believe it's the solution that the world needs to set people free.
Through workers like Gina and Jamie, OC Rescue Mission is ending homelessness one life at a time.
It's incredibly inspiring to see the change OC Rescue Mission is making in so many lives.
And speaking of change, our upcoming segment explores two Bulldog athletes who tried out a brand new sport after our announcements with Lisa. So take it away, sports.
I said you need me now. I said you need me now. You need me. Stick to the code, binary like eyes and nose. I'm too exposed, I gotta keep curtains closed. Her body bold, she hid it behind the clothes. I'm in Cabo, I'm hitting his adios. Trying to balance all these up and downs, but I keep popping lows. Man, it is what it is, that's just how it goes. Period session, I just kept progressing, finally found the flow. If the answer's down there with the devil, I may never know.
What's up, Bulldogs? It's Lisa, back with another episode of PNN Sports. Let's jump straight into some game scores. Our baseball team showcased their talent on the diamond this week with two impressive wins against Irvine. They first shut them out with a commanding 4-0 victory, followed by an impressive 2-1 win. In boys lacrosse, our team dominated their opponents, defeating Laguna Hills with a resounding 15-1 victory and clinching a hard-fought 8-6 win against Irvine. Meanwhile, our girls lacrosse team also triumphed on the field. They secured a thrilling 8-7 win against Uni and continued their winning streak with an 11-8 victory over Irvine. Now, on the volleyball court, our boys team defeated Woodbridge with a solid 3-1 score. Let's not forget about boys golf, who beat Sage Hill twice with a score of 196-199 and 188-193. Then they conquered University with a close score of 193-197, followed by a dominant 181-261 victory over Laguna Hills. Now, let's see what happens when two athletes try to switch sports in an exciting segment.
Hi, my name is Malika and I play lacrosse.
My name is Viana and I play softball.
And today we're switching sports.
Okay, so you do the shuffle and then you
Why go. Do we have to die for that?
Because you gotta do it in the game, you know?
People know. I did not catch it! I did!
It made me bleed.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Oh no! Oh! Just.
Yeah, just try to hear
Don't
me.
Hurt me. Okay.
So I just go like this? Can I do that?
You just have to like mirror
his face. What was that?
Like
what was I doing?
What was doing this?
Catch it. Yeah! Ah, what the? Is that not a foul? Thank you. Catch it? Can I? Oh, you're still going. Okay.
Stop it.
So playing lacrosse is definitely an experience. I don't know if I would do it again, but it was fun. What about you?
Yeah, playing softball was a little harder than I thought, but it was a fun experience. And yeah.
That's definitely way harder than it looks. Thank you both for participating in that segment. Well, that's it for this week's episode on PNN Sports. And now back to you, Shifa and Jonathan.
Thanks, Lisa. Now, with AP exams and finals coming up, many Bulldogs are prone to experiencing burnout, especially during this last stretch of school.
So, what exactly does burnout look like?
Well, let's take a look.
Biology in the chloroplast, right?
We will be spending 24 hours in this insane asylum.
That's surely an important message as we're right in the midst of test-taking season. Bulldogs, we remind you to plan ahead, take breaks, and most importantly, ask for help to avoid burnout.
And not to mention, making sure to have fun. Well, next up is Andrea with today's episode of Life.
Hey Bulldogs, welcome to another episode of Life with Andrea. For those of you watching, it's already past, but for us, prom is just around the corner and there has been a lot of buzz around campus, all the way from askings to voting for our court. Today, I'm going to be going around and asking students what their prom traditions are. So let's get started.
My name is Dean. I'm a senior at Portola.
Very nice. And you're going to prom, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Can you tell me what your favorite song to dance to at prom is?
Ooh, Fiend. If they're playing Fiend, I want to hear it a lot.
What outfit are you wearing? What's like, what color, what vibe are we going for?
So I'm going to be wearing all white. I'm going to be matching with somebody. It's going to be, yeah, all white fit. White tux, not tux, white suit, white tie, white pants.
Wow, that's really fancy. And on the night of prom, do you have any like traditions that you do? Like, do you go out somewhere before, take pictures, eat, or?
So it's gonna be probably, we're gonna go out, take pictures beforehand, and then go dance, have a good time. And then afterwards we go somewhere like Denny's, somewhere that's up late at night. Last time we went to In-N-Out, because that's up, and that was really fun.
Yeah, that's a classic, right?
My name is Izzy Vu, and I'm a current junior.
Can you tell me a little bit what your dress is looking like?
It's a yellow satin dress with a halter and lace in the torso.
What are your prom plans or your prom traditions? Like, whenever you go to a school dance, what's kind of like the schedule?
Normally we start like in the afternoon and we get ready, like usually at my house with all of our friends. And then around like 4, we go to like Pavilion or Laguna to take pictures. And then we all ride together to the dance.
Hi, I'm Evelyn.
I'm Zoe.
What are your guys' outfits looking like? Because some people plan way in advance for their outfits.
Just pink dress.
Me too.
And can you guys tell me, what is your favorite song to dance to at prom? Like, if you could request a DJ song, what would it be?
I'm gonna say You Belong With Me.
Ooh, okay.
Probably Dancing Queen by ABBA.
Wow, look at that. Now, let's head over to prom for a quick recap. You all enjoyed 2024's prom. I know I sure did. It was super interesting hearing about everybody's prom plans and traditions. Make sure that if you enjoyed today's segment, you stay tuned to the next episode of Life with Andrea.
That sure wraps up this week's episode. Thank you so much for watching.
We'll see you next time on PNN.